Hello, welcome to episode 15 of Galactic Civilizations III, my first look at the game, not having played it before. I've played Galciv 2 a long time ago. This is better than that, certainly the tech is more interesting. What this thing does, can't seem to do anything with it anyway. So I am doing quite well on influence and technology, and actually even conquest, but I think that's only because my influence is spreading my borders. I'm not actually fighting anybody. Nobody's attacked me, and I'm not inclined to go and start a war. Generally, that's the way I play. So I'm going to boost both technology and influence generally, and just see if I can get anywhere quickly. Suppose I'm doing all right, I don't know. Boosted research already a little bit. I don't really know this display very much, but I don't have much in the way of trade routes. I have one available, one more freighter I could build usefully. Oh, that one's busy. Let's leave that one and go to Hunter. I think I turned that one off. Yeah. Freighter. And we have some new ones. Ooh! Crikey Moses. Whoa. I think I need to build some new ships. Just in case somebody attacks me, yes. I can't do these by the looks of it. Carrier will be good for fighters. I guess it can carry lots of little ships. 192, 260, that's very good, isn't it? That's a couple of them. Dreadnought D. 240, 228. 450. These are some mega ships here. We'll lower property values anywhere it shows up. Yeah, it's alright. Just build the one. Overlord. Battleship. 72. Going down to the lesser things. Not so lesser here. 600. 640 even. Don't know why the mass is coloured in red on some of these. Because it's right at the limit, perhaps? Don't know what the difference is. They look pretty much the same. Okay. Even the little ships are pretty powerful. We're down to the teeny ships now. Don't know if anybody actually Well, that'll do as a fleet, right? So, done. I can set up some new fleet building elsewhere, perhaps. But I think the others are busy building constructors. Oh, this one's empty as well. Maybe I should build another super-duper fleet here somehow. Just for the sake of it, eh? Requires Durantium and the others don't. I get it. So slightly better shielding on these. Oh, I don't have any Durantium. Okay. Oh, what? What's happening? Nothing's happening. Okay. Oh, it's off. I don't know about fighters. I don't seem to have any, so... In case anyone gets any dodgy ideas, because when I look at the graphs, my military power here is a bit boring compared with the others. I'm way ahead on everything else. The tooltips kind of get in the way here, but it's just not military power. Researched. Everybody's eating dust there. Speaking of which, chosen that. Yeah, okay. So we're getting that. Oh, I've done it, have I? Looks like it. Anything super duper at the end of engineering that I can do then? Warfare, maybe. There's some engineering ones. There'll probably be a lot of, well, there's a little bit of warfare here. Governance is weak. If I want a peaceful. Victory, I'd better do some governance, I suppose. Right, the freighter. Got it. Whoa. Ultimate this, ultimate that. Let's go for United Planets clout, see what I can do, eh? Now, where can I trade? The Altarians are inevitably the best. Looking at the money here, 28.4, let's could go there. Did two in one go. Got it, right. Idle colony. Can I build something awesome? I don't know, really. Can the governor decide? Nope. Doing these anywhere now without considering the location so much. I hardly feel that I need to do anything else but just keep boosting the influence. Entertainment centres needed, right, let's build a few. See how it goes, right. Approval is low. Nice looking planet. I wonder if there are a load out there like that, eh? Oop. Research. And eminence. On to Majesty, yes. Britannia rules the waves. The gravitational waves. Basically it for this place, isn't it? Mm. Research is going fine. I don't need that. Let's have a cultural festival instead. There it is. I like to look at these little worlds. Yep, I don't mind. More two in one. Really rocketing through here. Battleship, yes. Mega warship, just in case they're a little worried. A little tick up in my military power there. Nearly done there. Approval is rubbish, so I'd better build some entertainment centres or something. And am I able to do any more with these? Yes. And biospheres, I can put them somewhere. Colony. I'll just tip. Oh, we're back on the world of the squirrels. Right, let me just make this button visible so you can see what I'm clicking on here. It's a little easier. You lose the stats, which are usually displayed at the top, but at least you can see what I'm doing, I suppose. Consulate sorted out. Looks like the Drengen have been clobbered. Upgrade starbase. Constructor. Research. Stuff. New tech. Go for it. Done. Idle ship. Another mega warship. Wow. Don't know where they came from all of a sudden. My warships have been weedy for ages. Fervor has swept across the civilization, and all our people caught up celebrating the great things we're doing. Hooray, hooray, hooray. Okay, let's get them to do something useful. The approval is based on our people's appreciation for what we're already doing. We shall continue doing it. Okay. Or, unskilled labour has limited uses. Let's contribute to various volunteer programmes. Ah, who knows. Send these eager young citizens into the military where their brave talk can be put to some actual use. Roll the dice. That is my biro. Of course, it's come up at number one again. There's something wrong about this biro. Well, it does have the word BIC written on the other side. I suspect what happens is it slows it down as it passes the BIC label, and therefore it is biased. Not to worry. War. Just in case anybody wonders whether I can build some powerful ships or not. And that is it, isn't it, for governance? Warfare, there was something here. Let's get on with it. Idle colony, well. Approval's pretty good, but a couple of entertainment pods wouldn't hurt, I guess. I would like to up the defences. Not really building ships here, so it doesn't matter. Can I build a second one? Yes, might as well. Right now then, embassy, consulate. Now I should be able to build some. A galactic stock exchange, how about that? Not that this is the greatest world to build it on, I think. Maybe I shouldn't go crazy about that. Just do a bank. Otherwise, let's boost my way towards super duper influence victory if necessary, right? British defense is very good now. Ideology. Ooh. Oh, I did a good deed. I thought I had this already. Oh, no, I haven't. All star bases generate influence regardless of type. That sounds like a good one. Ooh. No problem. Goodbye. Why is it greyed out? Can't build it yet, okay. Oh, there's already construction on the way, okay. A lot of research being done here. What does it need? Planetary defense. Integrity field protection. We can make people honest. No. That ain't gonna happen, is it? Oh, more tech. And more tech. Wallop. 0 point armor. Alright. Who should be leading? I think I should. They've all voted for someone else. But I win! Haha! There's not much I can do with this now, is there? There's no more terraforming possible. Let's just then go for some new stuff here. Oh. But a cultural festival, because that's my position. Is this affecting my victory? Technology's going way ahead. Done two. I don't know how to complete the construction of the Ascension Gate though, but we'll see. I think I have a couple of worlds. Whoosh. With precursor thingies of Ascension Gates on them. That's it for the military. I've got all of it. Engineering. Is there anything more up here? Yeah, there is. I thought I had this already. Oh, it's a two turns. I seem to have got it. So now I have to complete the construction of an Ascension Gate. How the deck... I have no idea. Right, how to build an Ascension Gate. I probably have to go through my colonies and find the thing. If I just pick one... Ascension Gate, oh blimey. I'm going to build it. Right. Well, let's find a colony which is highly productive. so I can build it quickly. Hunter. Okay. Just do what I want at the moment with this super technology here. Cultural approval, yeah, cultural festival. New tech, whatever it is. Can I rush it? Not at the moment. Come back in a bit. Just instantly, whoosh! What should we research now? Can I go back to Hunter and rush that too now? Yes. So that means I should in theory be about to win, yes? A technology victory. Do we get a super video, or is it just, you win? Oops. Somebody unblow that thing quick. Score 39, I don't know what that means. So there you go. Summary. Most expensive ideology trade. Ranking, hooray! I didn't expect I actually get in here at all. Oh, I suppose that's me, okay. Versus the other players, right. Naught on planets conquered. First for annexed. Ships built. Stylus is built. Second place with no star base is lost. I'm not quite sure how that works out. Found one ascension crystal and harvested the most points. There it goes. Whoosh! Faction power, economic power, military power, a bit dodgy, but top of the end. Population, influence, hooray. Well, how come it stopped? Is that like the maximum? Social manufacturing. A bit dodgy there. But leaving the rest behind. Military manufacturing, well, variable, but high at the end. Research approval. High at the end. Very strange. The Drengans with their malevolent culture not doing very well there. Treasury, hooray! Ascension points, whoosh! And that's it, basically. Goes back to the main menu. Oh, we get some credits, alright. I'll take Galactic Civilizations IV if it's as big an advance on this as this is on Gal Civ 2, will be very good. This is good. I quite enjoyed the game. It's a little bit tiresome, but then I should probably go to war a bit more if I wanted to be a bit more exciting, shouldn't I? Doesn't look like a main menu to me. Or if it is, it's not quite laid out in the most intuitive fashion. Most of these people are male. I've seen one or two females in there. Right, so there you go, and that's it. Bye.